Always have a plan B, no matter what. Better to be proactive than reactive. Today on rLounge, we learn to always have the upper hand. My boyfriend asked for a paternity test for our child. As soon as the results come and show he is the father, I'm leaving him. I'm a new mom to a baby boy who is my pride and joy, and though it's been a roller coaster adjusting to taking care of a baby, the past few months have been great. Tiring, but great. I have a boyfriend of 3 years who is the first person, relationship-wise, I have ever loved, and I thought we were doing great as new parents, but also as partners. Friday, he came home and he asked me for a paternity test. Just like that, it was completely out of the blue. I was putting away the dishes and he asked for one, like he was asking what was for dinner. I'm a different race from him, but our child, apart from the skin tone, is literally his mirror image from pictures I had seen of him when he was a baby. I was stunned when he asked, and his reasons were that he had to be sure he was the father. He had to have that certainty. All I remember as he was speaking is just immediately feeling pain. The man I love doesn't trust me. He would actually believe that I would screw someone else, cheat on him, and then try to pass off another man's baby as his. I have never, ever given him reason to think I would cheat on him. I have tried to be transparent and communicated, and it wasn't enough. He told me he would give me the time to think about this, that he wouldn't go behind my back and do this test, but for our relationship to move forward, he needs to be 100% sure. He repeated this because he, in his words, needed me to realize how serious he was. After thinking for a couple of days, I'm going to allow him this paternity test because I have nothing to hide. I never cheated and would never have cheated on him. Once it's proven that he's the father, I'm ending it, leaving the same day, and I'm going to try my best to be a cooperative co-parent with him. In the meantime, I'm coming up with my exit plan, a place to live, and a lawyer to work out a custody arrangement in court. I can't even tell my family or my friends right now because they would go nuclear. My first priority is our child. I hope the test was worth it to him. I'm not asking for advice or reassurance or to explain his side. I'm just realizing this part of my life is over now. What a way to start the new year, huh? Update. We did the paternity test my boyfriend wanted. My post was removed, so I'm going to post it here. It's been a couple of weeks since I posted and I have just been navigating things after. I'm going to call my boyfriend, Mason, to keep things clear. This is going to be long. I'm sorry. Also, why post on Reddit? I don't know, guys. I don't know. To clarify a few things, we're different races, but to my knowledge, his family plus extended is more than okay with it. His mother actually set us up. I went to a dinner party, and he and I were the only single people who had been invited, and we hit it off. She admitted to trying to set us up for months. We have had no issues with cheating or any situations where things could be sketchy during the years we have been together. We also haven't broken up or taken any breaks. Our son is his mirror image. My boyfriend confided to his cousin about the paternity test a couple of days after he asked me, and the cousin told his wife, and it spread like wildfire, especially in their family group chats. His mom put an end to the speculation, though, by doing a half and half pic of him and our son, but also by adding some additional individual pics of both of them. She posted the pictures in the family group chat and said, "Look at the old pics I found of Mason." After people commented, she said, "Actually, the one on the right is my grandchild, or this one isn't Mason." Literally, the family members just thought that it was the same person in all of the pics, and that some of the photos were taken in darker lighting. This is how much our son looks like him, which I find funny but also a little annoying. Like I carried you for 9 months, all for you to be a copy of your dad. I didn't see the group chat, but the topic died down when his mom did that. Anyway, we talked. When I had made the first post, I was so angry and planned to leave, but the anger was quickly replaced by hurt once I calmed down. I realized if I blindsided him like that, I would be doing the exact same thing that he did to me when he asked for a paternity test. I planned to ask him to talk, but I also didn't want him to think I was trying to get out of the test. So, beforehand, I booked an appointment at two different paternity test locations. I asked him to talk when he came home, and I made sure our child was at my mom's. I told him that whatever happened with this talk, the paternity test had been booked and would go forward. I basically asked him his reasoning, and when he started having doubts about paternity, was it a previous relationship? Did cheating happen? He said it was about a week before he asked me that he started having doubts. He said that he was on his lunch break one day, just reading articles, and he clicked on an old article about a man who found out his three kids weren't his after like 20 years. This led him into a rabbit hole of podcasters and YouTube videos that encouraged men to ask for paternity tests. While he thought those podcasters were idiots, he said that paternity was an exception. He said his reasoning was that some women have done this before, and he wanted to be sure. He said, "You know it's yours because the baby comes out of you, but how do I know? The test gives me that assurance." I was hurt by that, but I decided to explain how I felt. I said that for him, it was a rational request, while for me, it was basically him saying that he didn't trust me. It was him saying that he believed I would cheat on him, get pregnant, have him emotionally, financially, and physically support me during the pregnancy, and birth and basically lie to him while he raised another man's child. I told him that I understand that women had done this before, but the fact that he thought I would do this to him is what bothered me. I told him the truth, that when I was angry, I had planned to leave and that I even went looking into a lawyer, a co-parenting plan, and a new place to live. He was stunned that I would leave for something so small. I found that to be a weird kind of irony, that what he believed issuing an ultimatum about a paternity test and basically accusing your partner of cheating was something small. I told him I was really hurt by what he said, that I was still hurt, but that if he needs this peace of mind, that we would do it. He asked what about our relationship, and I told him I didn't know. We did the test 2 days later, got the results back after 3 days. He opened both of them, and to the surprise of no one, he's the dad. He was visibly relieved when he read the tests, and I don't know why that hurt more. It's been about 2 weeks from the results, and I'm still really hurt. God, I sound so pathetic. I feel pathetic. I thought the results would maybe relieve some of that, but it didn't. It's like a switch clicked when he asked for the test, and I can't find a way to click it off. I'm pretty sure postpartum is playing a part in this because all I do is cry and I wasn't like this before. I've also moved into the spare room, something he was against, but I felt bad because apart from when our son was awake, I'm sad all the time. I'm looking for a therapist. I don't know how people find therapists they like so quickly, by the way. And he wants to do couples therapy and he's looking for one. He already has a few appointments booked just to try them out. He wants to move on, marriage, more kids in the future, and go back to where we are, and thinks that our relationship is now stronger. Well, I'm just thinking, our relationship right now is weaker than a person on stilts. I don't know if I would say we are together. The physical affection is gone. I'm not in the right mindset, and I don't want him to touch me. We rarely talk about anything but the baby. It's awkward, and I'm trying to find a way back to where we were, and I can't see how. I'm going to try to fix this and try therapy, individually and couples. But I just have this feeling that it is basically a sinking ship. I hope I'm wrong. I want very much to be wrong. Edit. I really appreciate the kind messages. I know some people are worried, but I have a contingency plan in place. I have a lawyer. I've gotten a child care custody plan worked up during these 2 weeks. I've told my family, who are mostly close by. I have a rental property I own and I can go to. Our finances are separate, so I'm good there. I know myself, and I know I'm not in the right headspace right now. I'm staying in the spare room. There is no affection. Therapy, individuals or couples, will hopefully help me and will hopefully reaffirm that I had the right idea in the beginning. It's not as easy to move when there's a child, so I'm making sure that I'm mentally well, our child is good, and then I'll make a decision. Thank you for all your kindness and perspectives. I really appreciate it. I think you have the right to feel the way you do. It's totally blindsiding, and it really makes you wonder if he's projecting his own feelings onto you. Like if he was the one cheating all along, but is somehow blaming you for it, and thus questioning if his own child is really his own. That would feel like a huge betrayal. Postpartum is not easy, by any means, and I feel like this totally didn't help things. And so what? You take a paternity test for all your kids moving forward if you decide to get married and have kids? Is he going to question whether all of his kids are in fact his? This guy does sound like he needs some therapy. Update. I left. Things have gone downhill and under advisement. I can't really discuss it until things have been settled in court. I guess I'm really a cautionary tale on what can go wrong. Please, if you have concerns with your partner, discuss things beforehand, especially before you have a child. Thank you again for your different perspectives. Hoping to have everything settled eventually. Let's see what the community thinks. Futile Pancake 79 says, "My ex kept making jokes about our son not being his, getting a paternity test, etc. My response was always, go right ahead. Long story short, he was cheating." Sandwich Crackers says, "My ex never bothered with a paternity test after our eldest. He always says I was cheating with my best friend, but I'm white. My best friend is very dark-skinned black, and my ex is mixed. All four of our children are white, passing, and all but our eldest daughter are blazing lily white. He, however, consistently cheated throughout our entire marriage and nearly made me miscarry our youngest because he gave me chlamydia. Bonus, I'm mildly allergic to the antibiotics they most commonly prescribe for it. They give me unmedicated labor level cramps for about 24 hours after taking them. So guess who got to writhe in pain and nausea for 24 hours in her second trimester? Bonus, bonus, the antibiotics gave me bacterial vaginosis. Bonus, 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 the medication for the BV gave me a yeast infection. Mr. Funktastic C says, funny enough, I did something similar to the mom. This one lady kept telling me how my kid looks exactly like my wife and nothing like me. First off, the kid was like 1 year old, so you'd think it'd be a bit early to tell. Second of all, what parent wants to hear, huh, your kid looks nothing like you? Third of all, we were at a wake. So I pulled an old picture of me and showed the lady asking if she really thought my kid looked like my wife. Cue an in-depth explanation of the similarities. That's when I told her it was a picture of me. Jeez, yeah. I feel like whoever smelt it dealt it. Seems like the guilt from cheating or whatever really eats people up, and then they end up blaming their partner in some roundabout way to excuse their own behavior. Like if they cheated, I can cheat too type of thing. I'm sorry, OP. I'm glad you're out of there, and I'm glad you were smart enough to have a contingency plan. Good woman. Did you think OP was being dramatic? Thoughts? Thank you for joining us today on rLounge. Before you go, be sure to like and subscribe and hit that notification bell. If you have something you want to say regarding today's content, share that with us in the comments below.